Hi, it's Carly McAvoy. Today I'm talking about quadratics, and in this video I'm talking about things that you can determine just by looking at a graph of a quadratic equation. Remember, quadratic equations take the shape of a parabola when we graph them. Okay, so the domain. Well, the domain is asking what are all the possible x values that we can have in this for this function. Well, x can be anything. We can go out here and it's going to go way up high, but we can say x can be anything. So x can be all real numbers. One way to write that is to say I have a range from negative infinity to positive infinity. Another thing is you can say x is an element of the real numbers. So there's more than one way to write that, but to know that any x, there's no restrictions on the x. The second one is saying what's the range. Well, notice that our graph doesn't go any lower than this. It's higher than that point right here, but once we get to there, it's anything above that. So sometimes we can say, just say that y is greater than or equal to 12.25, because that's the value that I gave you for that lowest point. Can't see it without me telling you that in this case. Sometimes they ask you to write it as in set builder notation, the set of all y such that y is greater than or equal to 12.25. Right, so there is restrictions on the y. We can't go below that. We never go below that. What's the vertex? This is the vertex. The vertex is that point that where it starts to change. It's going down, then it starts to go up. That point is the vertex. So that's given in the picture, 12.25. Is the vertex a max or a minimum? Well, this is the very lowest point, and everything goes higher from that. So in this case, we have a minimum for our value. If you had a graph that was opening down, then that point would be the top. That would be the very highest, so that would be a maximum. What are the intercepts? Well, we have a few intercepts here. We have x-intercepts. You can have an equation that doesn't have any intercepts, but this one has two. It crosses the x-axis in two places. This looks like negative 3, so we would say the x-intercept could be negative 3, 0, but it can also be 4, 0. We have two intercepts. How is it possible that you could have no x-intercepts? Well, it could be that your graph looks like this, right? And if this was my graph and it was below the equation, below the x-axis like that, it's never going to touch the x-axis. So it is possible to have no x-intercept. Is it possible to have one? Yes, it's possible to have one. We could also have an equation that looks like this. And that very minimum point or maximum point, if it was the other way around, could be an x-intercept. So you could have two, you could have one, you could have none. But we had two in this case. What about y-intercept? Does it cross the y-axis? Well, it does. It crosses the y-axis right here at 12, negative 12. And so that's 0, negative 12. Only crosses the y-axis one time. Vertical line test. This is a simple test you can see to see if something is actually a function. You can use this by just thinking about putting a vertical line down across your graph. And anywhere you put that vertical line, it should only cross the graph one time. So if you're just looking at the right edge of my ruler, you can see that no matter where I move that right edge, it only can cross that graph one time. If this graph was on its side, let's say looked like this, then you can see that a vertical line, whoops, could actually hit that twice. And so that would be not a function. Using the vertical line test. The vertical line just says run a line down your function and see if it crosses once or more than once. If it crosses more than once, it's not a function. If it crosses once, it is a function. So in this case, our vertical line test told us, yes, that is a function. The last thing I have up there is symmetry. So symmetry is where does this thing reflect around itself? Sometimes they'll say, is it reflective around the axis? Well, it's not reflective around the axis here. You can see there's a little more to the right than there is to the left. It's actually reflected around that place where it's the vertex is. and that is at x equals 1. So the symmetry is a line, and we give that line as x equals whatever our vertex x coordinate is. So the symmetry for this would be x equals 1. That's the line, that's that vertical line, and it's symmetrical around that. You could flip it in on itself and it would look the same on both sides. Okay, so that's a lot of terminology and vocabulary, but I think you can get that and move on to the next part. Have a great day.